Wherever you are, close your eyes.
Unless you're driving or flying a plane, then absolutely don't close your eyes. Or if you're cycling, don't do that. Actually, keep your eyes open. Yeah.
And think,
with your eyes open,
about winning.
Feels pretty great, doesn't it? And now you can do it anywhere with the National Lottery app. Download the National Lottery app today. Play anywhere, win anywhere.
Uplifting lives one day at a time. Kimmy Kim and Elation's Radio. They're here to get your day going fine. Kimmy Kim and Elation's Radio. Kimmy Kim and Elation's Radio. Kimmy Kim and Elation's Radio.
And here's your host, Miss Kim Robinson.
The blackness. Keep on.
metaphorically can't quicker. Highs on prize, my pride won't collide. Am I right in your eyes if I stand on mine?
Boy, you are right.
Amen, amen. I had to do two songs from The Sound of Blackness because I am still in awe with Optimistic, because during that time, you know, Frank, you know, when you go through a lot of situations, this song is so powerful. And royalty is a reminder of who we are. Amen, amen. Welcome to Fellowship Friday with Kimmy Kim. And hallelujah. Yes. We have a wonderful, wonderful brother, Gary Hines, coming on to do a recap and just catch up on what's going on with him at Sound of Blackness, and it's an honor. Yes, yes, hallelujah. Yes. Because I love good music, inspirational music that can pick me up when there are times, you know, you may not feel like going to the Bible. I'm just keeping it real. And then when you have an uplifting song such as Black Lives Matter and Royalty, Optimistic, I Believe, it's just amazing. So let's first go to the Father in prayer, and then we're going to bring on my brother, Gary Hines. Father God, in the name of Jesus, thank you once again for your grace. Thank you for your mercy, Father God. Thank you for another day of purpose living, Father God. Each day I live for you. I thank you for just giving me the opportunity to worship you in spirit and truth, Father God. Let this Fellowship Friday be about you and uplifting the kingdom and spreading the good news of staying positive, optimistic in you, because we know all things will work out for the good, because you have told us that Jesus paid it all. So, Father God, we just want to continue praising you, worshiping you, because we know we win. And we will continue on being royalty and optimistic in you, because your spirit gives us the life in knowing that everything will be all right. So we thank you, we honor you, and we make this prayer in your son Jesus' name. Amen, amen. Without further ado, we have my brother, Gary Hines. How you doing?
I am cool again by the grace of God.
You remember when you say that, cool in the game. You know, I love that, cool in the game. You know, I still love cool in the game, their music, but just being cool in the game, wow, I like that.
by the grace of God, that's right.
Wow, you always have a positive attitude and tone about yourself. And I just thank you for that. There are times, you know, you feel down and then you hear this wonderful serenity voice. You know, it's amazing. So thank you so much for giving me opportunity to talk with you and just to spend some time with you on Friday, because I know you're busy, you know, writing good music. And thank you. But before we begin, who is Gary Hines?
Well, first of all.
Oh, I don't mean to do that. I'm so sorry.
Hello?
I am so sorry. We are here. We are here. I hit the wrong button. You know how these tunes work. Who is Gary Hines?
Well, that's all right, my sister. First and foremost, Gary Hines is a child of the king, and he is the proud son of the late Edward and Doris Hines of Yonkers, New York. So I'm a native son of Yonkers, even though Minneapolis now has been home for many years. And I'm also blessed to be a music director and producer for the Grammy Award-winning Sounds of Blackness, and that's just an amazing blessing and honor, and keeps us humble and focused at the same time.
Oh, my goodness. You sound so very, very humble, and with this wonderful group that's been you know, making good music since I've known. And I'm just amazed about how humble you are. What keeps you humble?
Spirit of the Lord, first and foremost. And, you know, being raised right, you know, again, shout out to the memory of both my parents kind of thing, and grandparents and aunties and uncles. In fact, I head back to New York to Yonkers tomorrow. The Yonkers Women's Association is honoring my late auntie. But all of them, you know, they say it takes a village, and that's true, the great African proverb, to raise a child. And so all of those entities and examples and mentors in my life were the guiding force, and it was always about doing your best, doing all you can, and being humble about it.
Amen. I agree with the humbleness, because it allows you to have a thankful spirit and also to spread what you have learned to others. And I'm seeing a new age of sound of Blackness. I mean, you have the, of course, you always have good music, but you even having like young people bringing them on and showing them the ropes. How does that feel, in knowing that you're spreading the love of sound of Blackness to other generations?
It's very gratifying, and again, humbling, but certainly very gratifying, really joyous, Queen Kimmy, because that's really at the core and heart and soul of what much of what Sounds of Blackness is about, especially, you know, reaching out across generations. And so in that line, a couple of things, a shout out, and it's so appropriate. You're always right on time, Queen Kimmy. And your selections of for Sounds of Blackness songs to play, Optimistic and Royalty, and especially on this day, and I'll tell you why and put it in the answer to your question. Of course, Optimistic, we give a shout-out, speaking of the current generation, to our brother Chance the Rapper, who's just a few hours away from Minneapolis here in Chicago, or that's where he's
based.
All
right. You know, I love you, yeah. Chance now.
Yeah, and the reason we shout out to him, you know, you played Optimistic, but of course, as I'm sure you know, because it's become a viral phenomenon now, you know, online, he's issued to the world and to the country the what he calls the Optimistic Challenge. And you've been seeing that. People have been submitting, you know, their video footage, you know, of their dances. Fathers and sons, kids in the street, gang members, youth, high school, churches, what everybody's doing, the Optimistic Challenge. And so Optimistic is coming at a first round level to another generation. And so we definitely give a shout out to him. And of course, Queen Kimmy was right on it in terms of playing Optimistic today. So that's just in the air. And we're still, you know, in the Easter resurrection season. So much to be optimistic about, even in the midst of all the world's madness. And then in terms of royalty, another shout out to you, Queen Kimmy, in terms of playing that today, because, of course, it was just a year ago today that we lost our dear brother of 40-plus years friendship that the world knows as Prince. And, of course, here in Minneapolis, you know, it's especially impactful. And, of course, there are celebrations and commemorations like all across the city, really across the state, as there should be, because Prince loved Minnesota. He really, really did. And I know personally, firsthand, he and I talked about it many, many times from day one. I mean, going back to, you know, his first recordings, Hollywood was trying to get him to move to Hollywood. And from day one, he told them that's not going to happen. You know, I'm going to build whatever I build right here in Minnesota. He loved the Twin Cities in Minnesota. So it's so appropriate. Oh, let me make the final connection. Royalty, when we lost him last year, Sounds of Blackness dedicated it to him because he was very instrumental in being a motivating force behind the creation of Royalty, because he would call me sometimes 2 or 3 in the morning, and I think it may have been our last, or certainly one of our last conversations that he called, and he really admonished me to, and you know, and implored me to make sure that the Sounds of Blackness really lived up to our name, as we always have, and especially in terms of reaching out to our youth and telling them about their African heritage. You know, so often the media downplays how Afrocentric Prince really was, but as a longtime personal friend, I can tell you, believe me, he was about the people. That's why Baltimore happened, you know, and his trip there and the song and all of that. But so we dedicated Royalty to him, you know, when we released it, you know, just about a year or so ago. And, you know, the timing was almost uncanny, you know, but that's just a hand of God. So for those two reasons, it's so right on time, Queen Kimmy, that you played Optimistic and Royalty today.
And you know what? The reason why I did that is because the Spirit's telling me I need a song that I know from the previous years, and Optimistic was one of my favorites because during that time I'm going through the, you know, the teens ages, the era of knowing who I am, and also in the midst of that, peer pressure, what to do, do I listen to my parents, do I keep on? So that was part of my era of growing up, and Optimistic came at the right time. Sound of Blackness was one, is as today is one of my favorite groups of all times because of the wonderful positive messages that you have, and you still are, you're still able to talk about the God, but you know how sometimes church music can be really, you know, too churchy. But, I mean, yes. I love it, but there are times it's too churchy. You want something that's inspirational. You want something I love. Because, really, God lives in you, and it should be a reflection of who you are. But when you have some songs that are just too churchy, and you're getting convicted based on their lyrics because you're not living according to the Bible, it can sometimes, you know, really allow you to have a better day. But when you have Sound of Blackness, it's just about optimistic, being positive, uplifting. You know, it's really needed. So I just thank you for that. And it did help me, in the, you know, earlier in my life, and making the decisions and staying positive. You know, we need more of those type of music for the youth. And with that being said, what are some of the future projects for Sound of Blackness? You mentioned Chance, and I love you for Chance. I didn't know anything about Chance until the Grammys, and I was really admired about how he was just so humble. I'm just going to be real. I don't keep up with the new era of the, you know, hip-hop because I'm still like a Tupac. I love my Tupac. And I'm trying, but, I mean, some of the music that I hear from the new artists doesn't reflect who I am. I don't talk about, you know, what I have and how many people I can get. I want to have like a Tupac moment, you know, give me some wisdom.
Yeah.
In the, you know, but we don't have that. But I saw Chance and he was just amazing. So what are some of your future projects?
Well, right now, Sounds of Blackness, of course, is involved with a number of things. I'll try to condense it down in terms of what's coming for the...
so much, huh?
That's okay. One, we are doing all we can to hopefully be blessed with a BET nomination for Royalty. Royalty has been blessed. Royalty was blessed with two Image Award nominations and with two Stellar Award nominations. So we're so thankful for that. And Image Award nominations are announced in just a couple of weeks in early May. And so, you know, we're doing whatever we can to position ourselves to hopefully help that happen. But in the meantime, in between time, we have just come off the Soul Train cruise by just a couple of weeks ago, and we've been continuing to not only perform, but also to – Royalty is a movement, and so we're really about continuing that movement, whether it's in schools, on street corners, churches, festivals, in performances, workshops, whatever it is, we continue to do that as well. Working on soundtrack possibilities for Royalty and beyond, and looking to release probably one or two more singles before we release our first live CD, which of course is entitled The Sounds of Blackness Live. And speaking of connections with our young generation, Queen Kimmy, The Sounds of Blackness Live was recorded with special guests, ACWC, and that stands for the Acapella Chorus of Wiley College. And
I'm jealous. I'm going to invite. Where's my invitation for that? Live sound of Blackness? Oh, cool. Oh, my goodness.
Yes, people, there's been a clamor for a Live Sounds of Blackness record since day one. And so after all these years, you know, finally getting to our first live one. And like I say, we were blessed to do it with the a cappella chorus of Wiley College under the magnificent direction of Dr., my good brother, Stephen Hayes. And everybody, your listeners and followers should know Wiley College from the movie The Great Debaters. So that's the same college, you know, of that fame. And their a cappella chorus is just outstanding. So we're prepping to release that later this year. As well, like I say, doing what we can for the BET and continuing to perform and workshop and everything we can, not only with royalty as a song, but with royalty as a movement. Also, we've been blessed. We're going to be included, inducted into the National African-American Museum, Music Museum in Nashville under the auspices of great ethnomusicologist Dr. Portia Maltsby. And that's scheduled for July, late June, early July, I believe. I'll have to get you the exact date. So they're having us.
I would love to come.
That would be awesome. Yes, that would be awesome to have you there. So in addition, as part of our, they're going to have an exhibit, a Sound of Blackness exhibit there. We're so honored by that. And so they're having me collect some samples of our early wardrobe and posters and CD covers and all that kind of thing to have as part of the Sounds of Blackness exhibit in the National Museum of African American Music in Nashville. So those things and more are what is on our immediate plate.
Wow. You're just like, you just gave me really some chapters. You're doing a lot. How do you make time for yourself with wonderful projects and you're traveling and you're making new music and you're producing? How do you have time for Gary with all of this? Or do you just
keeping it real? Keeping it real? Sometimes you don't have time for Gary.
It's a lot, but I love you.
Yeah. And if you saw my apartment, you'd know that I'm telling the truth. But I mean, you know, we do what we can. I mean, you know, there's a great book by the great football player Gail Sayers called I Am Third. And that's my philosophy in terms of, so it's not, I'm not important at all. I mean, and what I Am Third means is God is first, family and friends are second, and I am third. So, you know, that's okay, you know, if there's not, you know, time for me. But we're just blessed to do what we do.
Amen. I appreciate that because you're letting us know the importance of the purpose of why we are here. We're here to serve each other. And you're serving us with your music. And how do you write your music? Do you write most of them? And when you do write them, how do you get the idea of what to write about? Because royalty came at the perfect time. And the next ensemble that we'll be listening to will be Black Lives Matter. How do you get this inspirational in writing or producing these lyrics? Because they have so many wonderful meanings, not only to me as an African-American woman or Black person, but everyone, you know, to appreciate the Blackness of everyone. I mean, it's okay to appreciate that you're Black, but at the same time, it's okay to appreciate that you're white. It's okay.
That's right.
How, I really believe that people, like, I'm reminded, for instance, like in Paul, he has a passion for his people. I have a passion for my people first, but I love everyone. And I see nothing wrong with that. So how do you do that, you know, make these wonderful lyrics?
Well, first and foremost, only by the grace of God, you know, and there's a there's a wonderful from the late, great country artist, Chet Atkins, that I love, and that kind of answers your question, Queen Kimmy. And Chet Atkins said, there are no songwriters. All music is given. And I believe that, you know, even when we as songwriters, or so-called songwriters, sit down at the piano or guitar or whatever and attempt to write a song, it's still given to us. So, oh, we'll fiddle with it and fool around with it and hopefully not mess it up. But it's all given, you know, no matter how much we craft it. And so there's three ways I see that happening with others and with myself, just to expand on the answer to your question. One is what I call the more technical side, where, like I say, you sit down at the piano with it in mind to say, okay, I'm going to write a song, or I'm going to try to write a song about this, this or the other. The other is probably the most frequent, and that's the more what I call the event-inspired. You know, I mean, look at the late, great Marvin Gaye when he wrote What's Going On, Mercy Me, the Ecology, where you put on CNN or you look at the newspaper or whatever or on your phone or device and you see all the events, or you look out your window or you're on your street corner, you see everything that's going on in the world and some event inspires you to write. So that's what I call the event inspired. And then the third way is just the flat out God inspired way. You know, God, I mean, clearly just God given by itself, where you may not even be thinking about music. You may be driving down the freeway or, you know, putting your clothes in the cleaners or doing something totally
That's a good song.
And the next thing you know, here's this melody in your head and this idea, this lyric, and it won't leave you alone. You know, clearly that was just straight out given to you. So those are the three ways that it happens for me.
Wow. So it sounds like you have to be in a moment for me. That's what I'm getting. That's amazing, because when you're in that moment, that's, I think, is when you make your best piece or your best thoughts, or, and you have the opportunity to jot them down on a piece of paper. That's amazing. And another question, because, you know, you've been around for so long. How old is Sound of Blackness? I mean,
well,
I said wiser.
Great.
I said wiser.
Yeah, that's right. We began as Sounds of Blackness in January of 1971. So this is our 46th anniversary as Sound Gill. And yours truly is the only one that's been around that long from day one, by the grace of God. You know, so we obviously have, you know, a more current crew now that are continuing the tradition of Sounds of Blackness.
Yes. 46, who can say that? That's amazing. And what I like about the passing of the torch between the former members and the current ones is that you don't miss any flavor. It's like it's more of a, I mean, I can't say improvement because, you know, you guys are good back then, but it's like continuously good music. How is that possible? Because it's like, do you have a particular talent that you look for, or attitude, or what's their beliefs? Because I don't miss a beat from today or the previous music that I get from Sound of Blackness. When I do revisit and listen to the songs of yesterday versus today, it's the same message. How do you become so consistent with that?
Well, thank you, first of all, for that wonderful expression, Queen Kimmy. And first and foremost, as always, by the grace of God, you know, I don't have a whole lot of sense, but I got enough to know that. But then also always striving for excellence. You know, God gave us his best. And so, you know, it's incumbent upon us, I believe, for us to give him our best. And so with the current membership that we have, both in our band and our singers, and when we audition and bring on new members, we first of all look for a certain level of talent, you know, is necessary to, you know, to do the task. But also, you know, and probably at least as much, if not more importantly, a good heart and a right spirit, and to come to the place where the group has always been. And so that's how you achieve that continuity, by keeping that spirit, because that's the Sounds of Blackness has always been a family. We, you know, from day one, when the first group, the original group of Sounds members were at McAllister College, my alma mater. So shout out to McAllister, where Sounds were born.
And
Russell Knighton, you know, the founder of the McAllister Black Voices. We always considered ourselves a family. One of our most prominent alumni, the great Ann Nesby, who would want me to send love to you, always used to say, once a sound, always a sound. And so, you know, even though she's gone on to a solo career, a wonderful one, and our great brother Alexander O'Neill, who also was with Sounds of Blackness and has gone on to a great solo career, they would still tell you, once a sound, always a sound. So in the words of my dear beloved Sister Sledge, it's a family affair, and Sly and the Family Stone, it's a family affair. We are family.
I love that. We are all family. Amen. And unfortunately, the time has come. We have to not depart, but we have to schedule another wonderful fellowshipping time with you. And I just thank you so much for the opportunity. Before you go, I would love for you to give out your contact information and a synopsis of Black Lives Matter. That really, when that came out, I said, now you guys are keeping it 100, you know, because we need to have a song that empowers us, because fortunately, television, music sometimes don't give us the empowerment that we really need like it used to be. So can you give us a synopsis of that, and how can people reach out to you?
Certainly. You know, in the reverse order that you asked, Queen Kimmy,
however you want, it's your show.
Oh, that, oh, bless you. Yeah, so Black Lives Matter, again, was, you know, Prince, rest his soul, you know, being part as a catalyst, you know, for that, you know, because that, I wrote that right around the time that he wrote Baltimore, you know, and because of everything that was going on and that's still going on amongst our people. And, you know, we looked at how the movement has always had music in the vanguard, you know, with the civil rights movement, of course, it was We Shall Overcome, and with the Black is Beautiful and the Black Power movement. Of course, it's, the main anthem was Say It Loud, I'm Black and I'm Proud, the Godfather of Soul, my favorite artist. And we looked at the Black Lives Matter movement and didn't see or hear an anthem. And so I contacted Sister Alicia Garza, who's the president of National Black Lives Matters. And we said, you know, Sound is working on a song for you to use as your theme song. And so that was, you know, the impetus behind that. But we would love, for part two of your question, for all of your listeners and followers to please get in touch or stay in touch with us through our website, www.soundsofblackness.org, our Facebook fan page, Twitter, which our Twitter is just @soundsblackness, without the of, @soundsblackness, Instagram, and I never can remember our Instagram address. I apologize. My members are going to kill me. But those are the main ways, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. We're on LinkedIn as well.
Wow.
And we have a website.
Hello?
Hello? Oh, yes. And
okay. Oh, I was just saying amen, amen. Oh, continue,
yeah.
Please. Okay. Well, I just want to thank you once again. And you're on LinkedIn, Facebook family, please, please like Sound of Blackness. I just want to thank you for this wonderful opportunity. You're just amazing, amazing friends. And
thank you, Queen. Hey, thank you so much. And we would also want all your followers and listeners to go to YouTube and check out the royalty video and the Black Lives Matter video.
Amen. We're going to do that. Come on, family, let's do that. And can you pray us out? And before you pray, give us like a good thought for the week, something inspirational that we can grasp onto, because during the week, sometimes we may have our valleys and storms. Give us a word of encouragement, if you don't mind. And I thank you once again, my brother, for this wonderful time. And this is for you. You are the same Gary that I met 4 years ago. You're still the same. And I really appreciate that. And I thank you so much, my brother. This is I have to do another round of applause. Simply amazing.
Thank you.
Amazing.
Well, thank you, Queen Kimmy, and all of those feelings are very, very mutual. So we can't thank you enough, and please know that. So for that word of encouragement, I would take the first lyric, the first verse in optimistic, since that seems to be in the air today, which says, when in the midst of sorrow, there's a lot of sorrow going on in the world today. When in the midst of sorrow, you can't see up when looking down.
Mm.
But a brighter day tomorrow will bring. So that's a statement of faith. A brighter day tomorrow will bring. So that's an ongoing theme for Sounds of Blackness. Whether it's hold on, change is coming, don't worry about a thing, hold on, keep the faith, everything's going to be all right.
Woo! Come on, preach it now. I saw you got some word in you too. Okay. That was amazing. So please pray us out, and we're going to definitely keep in touch. And once again, I thank you so much for your time.
Thank you, my queen, and I'm honored to pray us out. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we just thank and glorify. We love and lift your name now and forever in the highest for all things. We pray your blessings on every listener on this entire station and program, on Queen Kimmy and all of her staff and crew. Thank you for all of your blessings, your protection, your prayer answering in every household, with each and every one, every family, every individual, every situation. And we just give you the glory in advance for all that you have done, are doing, and will do, now and forever, in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen, and you be blessed, my brother, and let's stay in touch, and thank you so much, King Gary Hines, and you're just an honor to have on Fellowship Friday, and it's just been an honor to have a catch-up. So I will be waiting on the future projects of Sound of Blackness and continue on supporting you. And I thank you so much for your time.
Thank you so much, Queen. You are royalty.
You are too. Take care.